Pisces, this is your tarot forecast for April, and the month is starting out with a celebration of sorts. Now, what is it you're thinking here, Pisces? Because why it looks like you've been working on a certain concept, and it might have taken a little bit of time here, maybe more than what you had thought initially. However, though, slowly, step by step, on this one particular project that you have in mind, well, this month is going to shoot up a little bit speed. Why? Well, it looks like things are coming together and being laid out in front of you, so you have all your tools, and not to mention the most important factor, which for you becomes time itself. It's having enough time to really focus now on getting things up and running that you've been over time now. I feel behind the veil, been working on. This should be the motivator of this month, because creatively here, when it comes to your career, I feel that something now is about to come out and be revealed. And I can go back several months here looking at you and seeing how you've been doing or working on this more like on a touch and go basis. So this is not your day-to-day job. That is running really, really well. I see you doing fantastic here as far as that goes. But it's this whatever behind the veil type project. This is what is going to take a leap here this month. Like getting ahead, all right? And that's what I feel it's all about. Now, this could come to strengthen your financial income. I see strength here. This is an Astro Tarot reading, so we're looking at your second house here with the Tarot. And here, now, strength. I see you moving ahead, feeling strong, empowered, taking direction as things now are surfacing, all right? You're looking at it, and once again, it's the timeline that has needed to come together for you to actually move as quickly as you have been desiring and now still desire. I feel it's bringing a lot of joy to you. I see you really feeling that much more invigorated and active, and also new surprises come to mind as well. And so here, keep that channel open, right? You're downloading here a lot of inspirational insights and also creativity. Good news if you have children, Pisces. It looks like from one of your children that there could be something really sweet going on in his or her life. And this is something, of course, for you as a parent that I see that you'll be very enthralled for and happy. And also, of course, as always, being supportive of what's going on in that child's life. I'm also seeing a message here coming to you from a younger person. So not necessarily your child, it could be grandchild even, for those of you in that age group. But I'm feeling that this news that's reaching your ears is definitely something that's going to put a spark in your heart and a smile on your face. And I feel it has to do with something now of coming together. It's a family-oriented situation, this news is. When we're talking about the home, well, what's going on this month? Well, I see how you're empowering the foundation of your life right now financially. There's apparently a big turnaround here this month, which is leaving you feeling that you have completed a certain thing, a certain issues. You feel good about the extra energy you've been devoting into this area. These last couple of months, it looks like you've been picking up and doing things that was needed to be done here in the home life. But this could also be related, of course, to your real estate or the home that you own or small projects or whatnot. It's like you've got that under your wings now and feeling that you are ahead of the game right now. So this is great. It frees you up, Pisces, to go do other things now that is going to be lined up for you here. Now, it looks like a female might get in touch with you, and she's not quite sure whether she should hang a left or a right, so she's smack in the middle of some decision-making, and I see her reaching out for you and wanting to know your take on her situation. So this could be a girlfriend, it could be a sister, but she seems to be a very wise woman in so many ways. It's just that she's now wanting to get things right, and she really appreciates your take on things. So You'll have some interaction with her, and I feel more than once, it might be a couple of rounds of it, when it comes to you looking at your daily life and your routine, the way you use your time, I feel that too can now be pinpointed here to for you to make a couple of decisions. Where do you want your time to go so that you can achieve the best results so time doesn't slip? And that's one thing I find a lot of times here with Pisces is that they've got so much going on that they never seem to have enough time, and time keeps slipping and slipping. And of course, the drain of time is also that part of your Neptunian energy, which is your ruler. So every once in a while, we got to take a little stop and look at what we have going on and create a new list of priorities just so that we can keep ahead of the game, right? So I see you doing that here at some point here in March. When it comes to relationships, this month here, Pisces, for you, there's stability. Don't really see any big challenges or any ups and downs, but I do see that you're going to be looking into something that has to do with travel. And we're not just talking like a day trip out of town. No, at this point, we're looking into more of a long-distance journey coming up, whether you're the one who is planning to go or making plans for somebody who's coming in to see you or be with you for a little period. And I'm feeling that this is something that could be quite inspiring, and I also feel soul healing. Just why? Well, it's because it's like I see your back is free and your future is open, and it's like you're wanting to create a beautiful time space for this to take place, all right? So it's something that is more than just a journey. It's something deeper than that. It's more of a soul spirit connection somehow tying into it. You're doing extremely well. Now here, there is an offer coming to you, being extended to you at some point this month. And if you so choose, you can accept this offer. I feel the offer in itself is good. Okay, so there's a lot of potential that's connected to it. But I love what's coming behind it, because there seems to be even more that can grow and become down the road. Summertime into autumn, which is great. This is a male. He seems to be an earth sign, so Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo. Now, don't get stuck on this sun sign itself, because it could just be the way this man projects his energy, meaning he's somebody who's very practical, he's down to earth, very analytical, he's good with money, security, and so forth. So this offer here, I feel he's wanting to take you with whatever skills you have and talents, he would like to take it and run with it. So it could be good. It's definitely worth looking into at the least. And there is this underlying energy here, Pisces, that you would really love to get to a point where you can not just accomplish your goals, because I do see you've accomplished several, but I'm seeing you would really love to get to a point where you could put some of them to rest so that you can really now start exploring other avenues, because you're multi-talented, right? And so it's like you, when you've mastered a certain level to a certain degree of your skill, then there's other skills, other talents that would really love to birth themselves. And so, but in order to do so, you've got to create more time. So here we go. We're back to the timeline thing again. How can you create more time to do the very things that you would like to do? And that means shutting down on certain things that you feel that you've already now mastered, accomplished, and whatnot. And how can you put them aside without losing anything? So that's going to be your big task here this month. And I see you going a little bit back and forth over the things, questioning yourself, having inner dialogues with your higher self. What do you really want from your future? We're not just talking April. We're talking 2016. We're talking down the road, years to come. What is it you really want? Because in order to really reach it, we got to put the timeline somewhere. And this is where I'm seeing that this month should actually be really helpful to you, supportive to you, in order to figure out what it is you want to do when you grow up, Right? So it's hard being multi-talented, and that is definitely something you are, and that is why you are the last sign of the zodiac, because you have evolved through all of these destinations throughout your spiritual walk. And but I find it really exciting for you. So bottom line, it's all about being true to yourself, true to your skills, talents, your walk of life. And yes, every once in a while, we got to make those priorities so they can stay on top of it all, right? So listen, this is what we have here for you, Pisces, this month. Of course, you're free to listen to your moon and rising sign in the tarot, just like you do with the astrology as well, to get a fuller read on what is coming up in this coming month. So have a good one, and I will see you in May.